Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? How about a super harvest, fourth in the series of a lunar tetrad, lunar eclipse? I know, that's a mouthful. It's a lot. But it's pretty cool, as there's a lot going on in just one event that occurs on Sunday, September 27th for most of us, and for some people over in Europe on Monday, the morning of Monday the 28th. What does all this mean? Well, let's start with the super portion of that, and that just means the super moon, which is really not that big of a deal. It just means that the moon is at perigee, which means that it's going to be closer to the Earth, so it will appear somewhat larger, as opposed to apogee when it appears further away. So the moon's going to look a little bit bigger. That means we would get a little bit longer lunar eclipse, because it will be passing through a little bit larger section of the cone that is formed by the Earth as it creates a shadow from the sun. And I'll show you that in just a moment. What we can also see, however, is that it's a harvest moon. Now, a harvest moon is one that is going to appear large on the horizon, but isn't actually large. That's just an optical illusion. And the way that you can look at this is when you see the moon like this, hold out your pinky at arm's length, like this. The distance across your pinky from one side to the other is approximately 1 degree. The moon only covers about a half a degree of sky. So therefore, when you look at the moon like this, with your covering it with your pinky, you can see that even though it appears large because there are objects in the foreground that make it seem larger, your pinky will show that it obviously still is just a half a degree. And you notice the color of that, and that's because you'll be looking through so much atmosphere. It's much like the sunset when it is going down in the evening, or even sunrise. It looks reddish from the bending of the light waves through the atmosphere. That's why you also get that color for a rising harvest moon. However, we're also going to see that red occur again later on in the evening, but for a different reason, and I'll show you that in just a moment. Now, the tetrad portion of this is because that there were four lunar eclipses that all occurred about 6 months apart. So the first one happened April 15th of 2014. The next one happened on October 8th of 2014, so 6 months after that. Then we had another one in April of 2015, and you can see that was really not viewed by too many people. We had a few people in Australia and the eastern part of Russia and Alaska that could see it, and lots of people really just kind of caught portions of it because much of it was blacked out. But this last and final one gets to be seen by a lot of people, and I'll go into more detail about who gets to see that as we go forward. But it's the fourth one in this tetrad series of eclipses. Now, a lunar tetrad doesn't occur all that often. The next time that'll happen will be starting in the year 2032, so 17 years from now. So mark your calendars, but it's not going to happen anytime in the next couple of years by any means. And we also get this supermoon harvest moon thing that happens at the same time this time. So that's kind of unique and different. Now, what is a lunar eclipse? Well, that's when the moon goes behind the Earth and winds up first going into the penumbra, which is a portion of the shadow, and then ultimately into the umbra, which is the section that's completely blocked by light, and then it reemerges on the other side. So we can see how the moon, actually you can see the Earth's roundness from the shadow caused by the Earth blocking the sunlight, which is definitely a neat thing. And you don't even need a telescope to see this. This is all naked eye that you'll be able to watch these things. Now, if you have binoculars, feel free to use them. If you have a telescope, feel free to use it. Certainly take photos if you can. If you've got a very long focal length lens of, say, 400 millimeters or larger, or through a telescope, it's a great event to capture digitally or with film, if you still use that. But this is basically what a lunar eclipse is. It's that the Earth is eclipsing the light of the sun. And so the moon is no longer lit for a period of time. And this time that's going to happen for about 72 minutes. So over an hour, we get this darkened moon happening through the sky, which is definitely pretty cool. Now, another thing that happens is we saw that other graphic. It was kind of showing the above version. When we look at what happens with the where the moon is actually traveling through the shadow, this that cone of light or shadow really cone of shadow from the Earth, we can see that the moon is really kind of coming through this lower section of it. It's not really going right across the full diameter of that. It's sort of below it. So we're going to get this bite that's sort of taken out. Now, the penumbra section of the eclipse, that's really just a slight darkening of the moon. You don't really see a lot of difference for that. It's really the umbral eclipse where you see a lot of difference in terms of how the moonlight changes. So when it hits that, you'll see this bite taken out from the umbra of the moon. As it goes into there, you're going to see that darkened color. It's also going to be red, and I'll show you why in just a moment. But well, that's why you'll also get that sort of strange looking bite taken out of that. And I will show you actually why that happens. Let's take a look at Stellarium. If you haven't downloaded Stellarium, go to stellarium.org and download this free program. It's really simple to use. I have this already set up for what would happen on the night of the eclipse. And we've got the moon here. Now what you'll notice is that it says moon two times. So we actually want to change that because we don't want to get, you can see what happens if we make the moon too large. What happens is that the eclipse shadow doesn't actually cover the moon as it should. So what we can do is instead of having to go all the way down and zooming out by manually like this, we can just click off scale moon. And now we have the moon at the actual size that it should be in the night sky. They scale it up just so that it looks a little bit more natural in some of the zoomed out versions of that. But we can zoom ahead in time and kind of watch what would happen with the eclipse going through that period when it would happen. And you can see that bite kind of coming out across the moon. It turns red. After it turns red, it sort of slides off and looks like it sort of slides off and up. And that's because of where the eclipse is actually occurring in the umbral shadow. So that's why we get that kind of view. Now, where can we see this? Or that is, who can see this eclipse? Lots of people. Pretty much everyone in North America, everyone in South America, most of Africa and Europe. And as you get over into Eastern Europe and into some of the Asian countries, that's when you really start to lose it. And even the Middle Eastern countries, you start to lose that as well. And apologies to much of Alaska and the Hawaiian Islands, you won't really see much. Now, what you'll have is over on this side of the world, that's where you're going to get the eclipse kind of at moon rise. So that's going to be in the evening portion. So everyone in the United States, this is perfectly timed for you. It's going to happen in the evening hours, in towards either late evening and or midnight. As you get over into Africa and Europe, you're going to be seeing this in the morning hours, and this is going to be before the moon actually sets. So what times does that happen? We can take a look at this here. Now, Eastern and Central times, this is perfectly timed. As you can see, 8 and 7 o'clock is when the penumbral eclipse begins, but that's really not much to see. What you want to see is the partial umbral eclipse. That happens at 9 and 8 for Eastern and Central times. And then the greatest eclipse occurs at 10:47 and 9:47, so still fairly early. You can see the European time zones, how that's much, much later. The greatest eclipse for Greenwich Meridian time is going to happen at 2:47 a.m. in the morning. So you need to get up really, really early to be able to see it even just leave the eclipse. And all these light gray times you can see, those are morning hours of September 28th on Monday. All the black ones are Sunday evening times. And I'll have this posted on eyesonthesky.com so that you'll be able to see all these various time zones and what times to look to see the eclipse occurring. Now, this is, as you can see, the lunar eclipse from one of the tetrad eclipses from October 8th, 2014. And I got this one. It actually had the planet Uranus right nearby to the moon, which was pretty cool. And as you can see, there's this red color as the moon is going into its deepest portion of the eclipse itself. Now, why does that happen? Well, as the moon goes through the shadow of Earth, light is bent through the atmosphere. So just like you see bent light at sunset and moon rise for that harvest moon, the light bends around the atmosphere of Earth and then sort of lights up the moon from light coming around the atmosphere. The blue light scatters outward, green light scatters outward. And because the moon is in shadow, you get this really dim reddish color of the moon, which makes for wonderful photos, of course, when you want to go ahead and take pictures, or even if you take some video of this. But that's why that occurs, is because you get that scattering of light outward for blue and inward for red, and the red is what causes that to happen. So that said, that's what's happening for this week. It's definitely a really cool event to check out. Make sure if you either get up if you're over in Europe, or stay up if you're here in the States, or in the Americas. It's a wonderful event to see, and hopefully we will all get clear skies. If not in North America, at least we'll have another opportunity for a full lunar eclipse in January of 2018. So with any luck, we'll actually get this lunar eclipse, clear skies, on Sunday, September 27th, early in the evening. Again, check eyesonthesky.com for times when you will be able to see this awesome event. Keep your eyes in the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.